Good morning. My name is Eric Gray, and I'm the president of Atssb, and I would like to welcome you to the 2021 Atssb Symphonic Band All-State Concert. I would personally like to thank all of you for your presence here today, and to the leadership and membership of the Association of Texas Small School Bands for the vision, leadership, and hard work it took to make this happen. I'm most proud and, at the same time, truly humbled to be counted as a member of this outstanding organization. This event was organized with one group of people in mind, your students. This event had to happen, if for nothing else, but to remind us not to take for granted every opportunity we can give our students to succeed and flourish. And this is truly one of those once-in-a-lifetime moments. These students were born to make music, and we absolutely had to do everything in our power to make this happen. I was on the elevator the first day with a student. He didn't know me. I did not know him. He looked at me and he said, "Thank you for doing all the work it took to make this happen." I'm a senior and I graduated last week. I would have gone the rest of my life without realizing how truly amazing this All-State Band experience was. I will remember these days forever, and I wanted to thank you for making it happen. Couple of thank yous to Jerry Warden and the entire band staff, band students, and administration here at Melissa for providing this perfect and impressive venue. In our short time working together, I've discovered Jerry is a dreamer of big dreams, and he has been telling us for over a year, "We can do this, guys, we can do this," and he was absolutely correct, because here we are. So thank you to the folks here at Melissa. ATSSB is celebrating its 30th anniversary, and kind of a unique story. Was anybody here 30 years ago when we had the first All-State Band? When the kids came out into the Scottish Rite Auditorium, the crowd started clapping, a standing ovation for those kids just being there. And y'all did the same thing. That was so cool. But only us old timers know about that. So a little bit of history there. We are celebrating our 30th anniversary. We had a celebration luncheon yesterday at the hotel, and it was partially sponsored by Kaleidoscope Adventures. So we would like to thank them for that. Special event at that luncheon yesterday, the executive committee honored our executive secretary, Kenneth Griffin, as the first inductee in the ATSSB Hall of Fame. So when you see him this morning, afternoon, after the concert's over, be sure to tell him congratulations. There's another group of people that we have to thank, and these are the folks that do the heavy lifting, the hard work, our All-State band organizers, our All-State Symphonic Percussion organizer, came in at literally the last minute, and she has done an outstanding job, so it's only fair that we recognize her and bring her to the front of the stage. From Melissa High School, Miss Bailey Petersma. And our All-State Symphonic Band Coordinator, Organizer, Miss Luis Zepeda from London High School. This is his third year to do this, and it takes quite a bit of time and energy, and we thank all of our organizers for that. Our clinician this morning is a truly outstanding individual. Another neat story: when we had our student meeting Wednesday night before tryouts, and I was talking to the students much like I'm talking to you here now, and I was announcing and introducing them to their clinicians. For the symphonic band, I said the name Mr. Brian Balmages, and throughout the whole auditorium, this ripple of ooh kind of went across. And the reason the students had that, or that had an effect on the students, is because since they were in beginning band and through junior high, and even today, his name has been at the top right corner of so many pieces and so much music that they have played, and so they recognize the name and the stories the directors tell, and it has been an amazing experience to watch this man work with these incredible students. And so there's a lot of awards and accolades there listed in your program, and I'm not going to read all those, because you came to listen to these students make music, and you are going to be amazed. And so please, welcome to the stage the 2021 Atssb All-State Symphonic Band, directed by Mr. Brian Balmages.
Thank you. I promise that contrary to the way it looks, we did have fun for the past 4 days. Those of you that were watching your students or your children go home and ice their fingers, now you get an idea why. That was the easy one. We opened with Danse, Diabolique by Hellmesberger, arranged by Takahashi. It was a beautiful piece written originally and performed by the Vienna Symphony Orchestra, and this is a wonderful transcription, Vienna Phil. And so this is a wonderful transcription that really moves all of those violin parts into the woodwinds and brass, and they're just there's a lot going on there. And it's really hard to believe that on Wednesday the vast majority of this was sight reading. And I cannot say enough about their work ethic and everything that they have done. The piece that we're going to perform now, Escenas de los Aztecas by James Barnes. It's a piece that not a lot of people actually know, even though it was written several years ago, because it's published by a publisher in Belgium. It is a wonderful piece that tells the story of the ancient Aztecs and goes through everything from these jaguar themes, moments of worship, into this very mystical encounter in the middle section. There is a section that I think a lot of them love, the human sacrifice. I don't know what that says about them, but I'm going to just leave that one with you. And it's a very engaging, very musical, very descriptive work. And we certainly hope that you enjoy this Escenas de los Aztecas. It wasn't lost on me the circumstances behind everything in the world when I chose to program this next piece by a dear friend of mine, Julie Giroux. This piece, Hymn for the Innocent, is a piece that she wrote for the United States Air Force Band. So of course we can play that. And it was dedicated to Larry Lang, their colonel and conductor at the time. Hymn for the Innocent is a piece that she wrote to honor all of the people in the armed forces, all of those in the military, all of those in police, everybody who has given their lives to protect our way of life, to protect what we have here. It was also written to honor all of those. Keep in mind, this piece was written years ago, who have lost their lives to disease. And I know that all of us have suffered tremendous loss over the last year. And it is for all of you, whether personal experience, whether related to disease, whether it is to honor a member of your family in the military who is serving overseas now, or to offer somebody who is a first responder who gives so much of themselves and their families give so much. This is for all of you and your families, so I certainly hope that you enjoy this very powerful and moving piece, Hymn for the Innocent.
Thank you.
Sorry. It's... You go for a year without getting the chance to make music, and then you work with kids like that. So before I say anything, I have to acknowledge this incredible organization, this incredible group of people, this group of leaders who refuse to back down when the whole world seemed to be against them, and that is the Atssb organization. And there's a lot of you here. There are the band directors here that have been working with their kids for whatever restrictions, whatever situations, whatever protocols have been put in place, and they have found a way to give these kids what they so desperately need when everything else is being taken away. And for the board, for Eric Gray, the president, who has vision for this entire thing, for the incredible Kenneth Griffin, who has been about the most amazing communicator, organizer that you could possibly ask for Luis, my wonderful, not only band chairman, but friend, and for every single band director that I have met who has been so gracious, so kind, so appreciative. I think that it is about time that we recognize ATSSB for the incredible organization that it is, and I would be remiss if we didn't even give them a standing ovation for making this happen. I would love to finally close our program with the commissioned work that ATS, by the way, I write music, right? And the piece that we're going to perform, it's a piece called Breaking Through. Through, I got it right, guys. And I wrote this right in the middle of this pandemic. And it was a turning point for me, because it was a moment where I realized there is a way forward. Things are going to come back, and we need to be able to celebrate that. And to have a premiere at an event like this, where we really, I mean, this is what it's all about. It's about having this wall put in front of you, this idea of not being able to move forward, and an organization, a group of young men and women finding a way to push forward. And it's not just about the event, it's not just about the pandemic, it's mostly about the young men and women on the stage, which are going to be the leaders of tomorrow. How do I know it? Because they've given everything they have for 4 days, right? And every time I say, all right, we need to work this through, even though every part of their body hurt, even like muscles they didn't even know they had hurt, they pushed through. They found a way, and they even tried to smile even though their face muscles weren't really responding at that point. And so this piece, Breaking Through, it's a celebration of everything, of everyone. It's a celebration of you parents who pushed and found a way to create some kind of normalcy for your children. It's a celebration of ATSSB, which figured out a way, months away, in a different location, a different time, a different venue, and they found a way to make it happen. And it is a celebration of all of you on this stage who would not let a pandemic get in the way of what you love. We're proud to present the world premiere of Breaking Through. Thank you all so much.
Thank you.